Hi, job seekers! My name is Ayi Rapirap and I'm from morethanjobs.com.ph. For this episode of More Than Jobs On Air, ay pag-uusapan natin kung ano ang mga naging epekto ng napakaraming pagbabago dulot ng COVID-19 sa mental health ng mga empleyado dito sa Pilipinas. Makakasama natin si Ma'am Cielo Marte Presas at Sir Marco Antonio Rodas para i-explain ang mga usual mental health issues na nararanasan ng mga employees, ano ang mga epekto nito sa kanilang trabaho at sa kanilang pamilya, at kung paano makakatulong ang mga employers nila to prevent these problems from happening. Malaki po ba ang naging impact ng pandemic sa mental health ng mga empleyado?
Yes, it does. It did. Actually, we have observed this already in the many clients that we have entertained in the past year. We have yung impact of working from home. That's one. Because work is really in a workplace, right? And then when the home, which is the safe place, will become the area also for work, the inability to divide, to put a dividing line, will affect a lot of people. It has affected a lot of people. People are different. Some people can take it, you know. They are people who can work from home, work at home. There are people who can adjust immediately, no? Iba-iba ang make ng tao kasi. And dahil iba-iba yung make and foundation of who we are right now, our adjustment in order to adapt to this will affect, of course, our feelings. And in the course of the process, especially for the social type of people who are now kept from interacting with others in a physical sense, it causes them to be sad. Sad naman ako, hindi tayo makakapagkita, you know. But if the sadness, which is a feeling, becomes something even deeper and people don't know anymore why they cannot get out of the, you know, the path of sadness, it now becomes more depressing.
Ano po ang mga signs and symptoms ng mental health problem?
The signs of a mental health issue in the workplace would primarily be the decrease in productivity. And then this is accompanied by hypersensitivity, social maladjustments, exhaustion, and poor personal hygiene. That's directly manifested.
Ano po ang mga types ng mental health issues na nai-experience ngayon ng mga empleyado?
So typically, it's depression and anxiety. They surface as the common mental issues because of its direct negative nature with employment pressures and stresses. If you're too anxious, you are actually predicting that something bad might happen. So it directly affects your efficiency. When you're depressed, your mood is so down, you're demotivated. Usually, these are the common problems that employees are encountering when it comes to mental health issues. They are common in the workplace these days.
Paano po nakaka-apekto ang mental health issues sa mga organization?
The effect of mental health has a very strong effect on the behavior of their workforce. I had a discussion with one company and then they have identified 3 or 4, I think it was 4 people in the company who are not just depressive but having issues at home that causes the person to be overly angry, laging maliit na bagay lang may flare up, or very touchy-feely. So, you know, because any change in your behavior will affect your output, and your output is what the company pays for. And of course, the company would always want their employees to have high productivity, and if the productivity is affected, then they need to address the cause. So for others, they give the mental health trainings as a preventive measure so people would know when they do come into that position, they would know what to do, and the company can inform their employees immediately that there is something that the company has done in order for that to be addressed.
Sa mga previous sessions niyo po, ano po ang mga common mental health issues na nare-raise?
It's loneliness, especially yung mga lag, mga time na they're not working, and then usually they will be hanging out with friends, they cannot do that anymore. So finding time to do something to that empty space, that's common. I have heard a lot of people tell me that same thing. Wala ma'am akong magawa, naluloka na ako. Tahimik na ma'am, wala na akong pupuntaan. Wala akong kausap. And it actually is aggravated by the fact that even, you know, in Metro Manila, some of the trainings we had, they're either in Manila, no? They have, they actually live alone or live with friends. And then another one is the tension because of the home. She is working, no? Mas gusto niya nga sa trabaho kasi mas na doon daw ang kanyang peace. Because pagdating sa bahay, she is juggling several roles. And because this is causing her stress, her mental health is affected. Meaning, yung state of well-being niya is affected. And she acts differently, meaning she easily flares up. And she doesn't want that kasi she doesn't want to eventually become physical. And that is, that happens actually. Yung sobrang pagsisikip na nantintig mo, sobrang inis mo na, bilis mo na magalit. Yung next niyan will be, you know, releasing that pent-up emotions and that power within you na gusto mo ilabas. The only way you can do that is, you know, pag nagalit ka, you might slap somebody. So, nag-aalala siya doon kasi puro pamilya na yun. Na dati, pasensyosa siya and now she became irritable. And that's one thing that actually one thing that pushed her to talking to the person, to talking to her boss, to talking to her manager.
Why should people seek help?
Firstly, you might be misdiagnosing yourself. And if there's a reason for you to seek help and no one is there to assist you, then whatever it is that's going on in your mind, you might do. And an example to that is people will say, I don't like this anymore. I feel lonely. I just want to kill myself, you know. And if someone is not there to be with her, and then someone is not there that she can talk to, she might do it. So it is really important that we don't, you know, we don't let it reach that stage. We see the immediate need to recommend the person for treatment. Immediately, if we see any symptom which is different, and you know, dalawa lang nga ulit yan eh. It's either the person will be a threat to herself or she will be a threat to other people. And then, if you see that it's happening or likely to happen, preventive measure already seen. The likes of Dr. Marco.
Ano po ang mga tips na pwede nating ibigay for employees who are experiencing mental health problems or issues?
I have a very simple suggestion. One is get enough sunshine, eat right, exercise, and have a chat with friends and loved ones. Kasi yung sunlight alleviates you from depression. It also promotes production of happy hormones. When you get enough sunlight, you're giving yourself a fighting chance and your brain is producing serotonin. At least it alleviates you from going down or depressing yourself. Basically, all of my suggestions are neurotransmitter enhancers. Exercise also makes you produce happy hormones. Kaya may mga tao na may addiction sa pag-exercise kasi nakakakuha siya doon ng happy hormones. Ganun din sa sunshine. Kaya ang dami ngayon, if you can see, many bikers, no, mayroong addiction sa biking. No, they are happy doing it. Akala nila yung ano lang, yung leisure nun yung nakakapagpasaya. But the physical activity of that leads to a high production of happy hormones like dopamine and serotonin. When all else failed, consult a professional.
Why should organizations have mental health webinars for their employees?
Iba yung concept na dinidiscuss sa book or sa babasahin mo lang online. Iba kaysa dun sa meron kang ka-interact. And because we're talking about mental issues, so ganda naman na you do it personally then. That's why when we did the training, we considered yung attention span. We considered we considered the attention span of the audience. We considered the age of the audience as well. We looked at their their position level. Then we also looked at their marital status, and then we looked at where they live. When we had that profiling, we had a better understanding of what the audience need. So we were able to fashion that training to that.
Paano niyo po matutulungan yung mga companies na gustong magkaroon ng mental health webinars?
Recently, I partnered with Ms. Vivian Cruz. She's the owner and the managing director of ILIP Philippines. Now, ILIP Philippines is a training company, and our target this year is to be able to run variety of mental health training, not just to private but for government as well. Now, it is based in Ortigas. It's based in Ortigas, and if you want to reach her, you can just send her a message on LinkedIn or on Facebook. ILIP Philippines, ILIP PHL, and Vivian Cruz, and then on LinkedIn or Facebook, we're both there. And then me naman, if you want to go to ILIP via myself, you just go to Facebook and look for my name, send me a message, or you can look for Cielo Speak, just hashtag Cielo Speaks, because I speak often. So you can look for that online. It's available on Twitter, on LinkedIn, and on Facebook.
Once again, this is Ayira Pirat from morethanjobs.com.ph. And for interview tips, job openings, and more, please do subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on our social media pages, and you may apply on our website, that's www.morethanjobs.com.ph. Till next time, job seekers! Bye!